Hi everyone, so today in this video we are going to learn about the chapter the fundamental unit of a life. So the fundamental is nothing but the basic life. Okay, what is the basic unit of a life is nothing but you all know that in your previous class cell. So in this chapter we are going to learn about how the organism body is built. Okay, so here while examining a thin slice of cork, Robert Hooke saw that the cork resembles a structure of honeycomb consisting of many little compartments. So here cork is nothing but the bark of a tree. Okay, the small part of here cork is a substance which comes from the bark of a tree. So slice is nothing but piece, a small piece. Okay, a person called as Robert Hooke, a scientist called as Robert Hooke, what he did? He has taken the cork and he cutted a small piece of it and he observed this thing in a microscope. Okay, so microscope is nothing but it. So you are going to learn here. So this is a microscope, but a compound microscope. Earlier days, it was very simple microscope. By using a simple microscope, Robert Hooke observed that the cork in the microscope. He observed how the cells or he observed some compartments. Compartments is nothing but some block-like things he observed. So he observed the hexagonal shape-like things. He observed this kind of compartments in the microscope. Okay, he observed such kind of thing and it exactly looked like honeycomb-like thing. Okay, this was just like the honeycomb structure, we can say. And this compound, this microscope was self-designed by himself. Okay, so Robert Hooke called these boxes as cells. He called these structures as the cell. Okay, and he called them as cell. So this is a cell, this is cell, this is cell. So together he called it as cells. So why he called cell because, or why he named as this compartment as cell? Because cell is a Latin word from a word for a little room. So in Latin, for a little room we are going to call it as what? Cell. So that's the reason why he called them as the cell. So in Latin, cell is nothing but a little room. And this may seem to be very small and insignificant incident, but it is very important in the history of science. So you can say that this is very simple. He took bark and he observed in a microscope and he called he got some hexagonal compartments and he called them as the cells. Okay, we can say this thing. It is not a big thing, we can say, but it created a history of the science. Okay, it is a major part, we can say. This was the very first time that someone had observed that living things appeared to consist of separate units. So from this thing only, they concluded that all the living things are made up of some small separate things. Okay, the use of the word cell to describe these units is being used till this day in biology. So from the year 1665 to present today, we are going to call this compartment as the cell, or we are going to use this word cell in the biology. Okay, so let us go for deeper in for this cells, or how they are made, what are the types or various forms we can see. Okay, so what are living organisms made up of? So you all, from this earlier thing only, we come to conclude that all living organisms are made up of cells. So let us go for the activity to understand this thing. Okay, so here let us take a small piece from an onion bulb. So this activity is so much familiar, or we can say from here you will be familiar with this activity. So what you have to do in this activity, you have to take a small piece of onion bulb. So, okay, so onion bulb is nothing but the onion which you are going to see in your house. Okay, you have to take the onion and you have to cut it. You have to take one small piece of this onion and with the help of the forceps. Forceps is nothing but you are going to see a structure like this, you are going to hold here and from here you are going to take that. Why? Because if you open with your fingers, the cells, or they are going to damage, or they are going to piss it off. So that's the reason you have to peel off the skin with the forceps. We can peel off the skin, and the first layer of the skin we are going to call it as what? Epidermis. Epidermis is nothing but the first layer of the skin. For every living organism, we are going to call that first layer of the skin as the epidermis. So dermis is nothing but skin, and epi means outer. Okay, from the concave side, inner layer of the onion. From the onion, if you see it, if you see the onion properly, you are going to see some layers like things, right? So you have to take this half layer, and so the concave layer is nothing but this layer. You have to take it, inner layer of the onion, and this layer can be put immediately in the watch glass containing water. So watch glass is nothing but a glass plate like thing which is made up of glass. Okay, so small plate like thing will be there. In this you have to take water, and in this water you are going to put the piece onion, epidermis or the onion skin, you are going to put it. So this will prevent the peel from getting folded or getting dry. So you know that if onion is, so why you are going to put this in water? Because the onion should not, the skin or the epidermis or the layer should not get dry, and it is not going to get folded. Okay, so now what we have to do with this peel? So let us take a glass slide, put a drop of water on it, and transfer a small piece of the peel from the watch glass to the slide. So slide is nothing but a rectangular shape glass only. This we are going to call it as slide, and you have to take slide from the watch glass. You have to, with the help of the forceps again, you have to transfer this onion peel into the slide. Okay, so you have transferred this thing into the slide. Make sure that the peel is perfectly flat on the side, and it should. So what happens, some drop like things appear when you are going to put this peel on the slide. So it should be very much attached to the slide without any drops. So a thin camel hair paintbrush might be necessary to help transfer of the peel. So with the help of the forceps also you can transfer, and with the help, or else with the help of a paintbrush. So small paintbrush will be there, very thin paintbrush, you know it, right? So by using that paintbrush also you can transfer this onion peel skin, onion skin onto the slide. Now we have to put a drop of saffron in solution on this piece, followed by cover slip. So saffron in solution is a chemical which is gives a color to this onion peel. Okay, orange red we can say saffron in solution, or it is saffron color we can say. So you have to, so make me the bigger image here. So you have to take the slide, and you have to put the onion peel here. Okay, and with the help of paintbrush you have to flatten this, and on this you are going to add saffron in solution, and after putting saffron in solution you are going to add a cover slip. Cover slip is nothing but very thin glass thing. Okay, same, it just looks like a glass only, very thin it is. So you have to put it, and you have to take care that to avoid air bubbles while putting the cover slip with the help of mounting needle. So mounting needle is nothing but you are going to see a needle, this is the handle, and a needle will be like this, exactly this shape. So with the help of this needle you are going to put the cover slip. So why you are going to use this needle? Because while putting, some air bubbles will appear. So to prevent that air bubbles you have to use this needle. Okay, so you have to prepare a temporary mount of onion. So this is the temporary mount of onion peel. So this slide thing is nothing but this is the onion peel temporary mount we can say, and we have to observe this thing under a low power followed by high powers of compound microscope. So compound microscope is nothing but it is very much it is we can zoom in or we can see more bigger. So the that is nothing but the compound microscope. So here is the structure of the compound microscope. So first we'll go for the experiment, then I'll explain about the compound microscope here. So here you are added the slide here. Okay, So these are the holders, we can say, or the slide clips that which is used to make the slide not to move. Okay, so you have to, here you have kept the onion peel here, and from here eyepiece is nothing but from where you are going to see. So from here you are going to watch it. Okay, so from here if you watch it, what happens, this onion peel is going to absorb here, and how it is going to look, you are going to see this kind of structures, hexagonal shape structures you are going to see, right? So these are exactly hexagonal things, right? So these are called as what, cells. So Robert Hooke observed this in cork cells, and we observed this in onion peel. Okay, so and in center you are going to see some dark things. That thing is called as what, nucleus. And the hexagonal compartments are nothing but cells. Okay, so now this is the experiment to understand how the cells are going to look. So let us go for the microscope and how it is going to look. So this is the structure of the microscope, and it is having some few parts here. So let me explain how you are able to see the cells, or how you are going to see this minute structures in the peel, or how. Okay, so this is the eyepiece. Eyepiece is nothing but it is the area from where you are going to observe it. So you are going to close one of your eye, and we are going to see with another eye here. You are going to observe here. Okay, so this is the coarse adjustment, and so these are, you are having two adjustments here, coarse adjustment and fine adjustment. So coarse adjustment is nothing but roughly we can see the structure, and fine adjustment is nothing but we can zoom in. Okay, so that is the difference between these two adjustments. And this is the arm from where you are going to hold the microscope. So from here you are going to hold it, so they call it as arm. And here objective lens is nothing but here you are going to see the lens here. So lens is nothing but just like the, you, so that you can zoom and you can see the structures. Okay, so this is the objective lens, and this is the body tube. So from it will is having a tube, and it is a body tube and clip. So this two clips will be there to hold the slide here. And the microscopic slide, as I said, this the rectangular thing is called as what, slide. And here condenser, and this is the stage or where the slides are kept and watched. Okay, swivel, here nut like thing will be there to bend the, or to bend the microscope. Okay, this is the swivel, and here a mirror is placed here because to get the sunlight. So from here you are going to get sunlight, and you can observe the slide here or the object when sunlight falls here. This sunlight is going to pass through this, and then only you can see the image, or okay, or else you are unable to see the, in darkness you are not able to see the objects through the microscope. Okay, sunlight is necessary to watch the images or to get the structure of an object. So next it is the base. So it is also a stand like thing to get the base. Okay, so it can sit there. So these are the parts of the microscope. If you have any doubts regarding this microscopic part, you can comment me so that I can answer you. So this is about activity. So one more thing I forgot to say here, you are having, this is also a lens here. So you'll be having, and another lens is backside of this. So three lenses or two lenses you can see in the microscope. So these lenses of 10x, 20x and 40x, or it also may be 100x you are going to see. So because this 10x, 20x is nothing but, so the image you are going to see 10 times bigger, 20 times bigger, 40 times bigger, 100 times bigger. Okay, that kind of lenses are arranged. So you can move these lenses, and you can, if the magnification increases, the size also increases, and you can see 100x, you can see more big Okay, so that is the. So you have seen these hexagonal structures in the microscope, right? So let us go deep into these structures. What are these structures? These structures look similar to each other. They look similar, okay? Hexagonal is nothing but all the things are hexagonal only. If you take the onion peel, if you take any particular thing, the cells are same. So here we are not going to find one is hexagonal, one is rectangle, one is square. So we are not going to find this kind of things. We are going to see all the sizes are same. Together they form a big structure like an onion bulb. We find out from the activity that onion bulbs of different sizes have similar small structures visible under a microscope. The cells of the onion peel will all look the same regardless of the size of the onion they come from. So if you see, some onions will be small and some onions will be big. So that doesn't mean that they are having small cells and they are having big cells. So all the cells are having of same size and they are having same. So in this activity, what you have to remember, whatever the structures you are going to find, they are having same size and same shape. You are not going to find any different shapes, okay? And size is also of same. These small structures that we see are the basic building blocks of the building units of the onion bulb. So these cells make a full complete onion, okay? So these structures are called as what? Cells. Not only onions, but all organisms that we observe around are made up of cells. Not only the onions, whatever we even human beings are also made up of cells. Every living organism is made up of cells. All the living organisms are made up of cells, okay? We have to remember this thing. However, there are also single cells and that live on their own. So here we are going to see each one cell. We are going only this one compartment, we are going to call it a cell, okay? So group of things, we are going to call it as tissues. We are going to learn it later. So but these are cells, okay? Single cell or multicellular, okay? As you can see, many cells in this activity, right? You are not going to see only one cell. So we are going to see many cells here. So these are made up of multicellular, and single cells are also the living cell organisms. Few organisms are made up of single cell also. We'll see later about that. Let us know some more thing about cells. So cells were first discovered by Robert Hooke in the year 1665. As earlier we discussed, a person called as Robert Hooke, he discovered the cells in the year 1665. You have to remember this thing, and this is a very basic thing everyone should remember. He observed the cells in the cork slice with the help of a primitive microscope. So in the year 1665, what is his name? Robert Hooke. What he called them as? He called them as cells, and with the help of primitive microscope is nothing but very simple microscope, okay? Not the compound one which we have seen in the figure, okay? So Leeuwenhoek, next point, in 1674, another person or another scientist with the improved microscope discovered the free living cells in the pond water for the first time. So first Robert Hooke in the Cork in the year 1665, he observed cells. So in a very basic microscope. So next, Leeuwenhoek, another person in year 1674, with the help of somewhat improved microscope. Okay, the microscope which was primitive, that was improved, and from the improved microscope, he discovered another cells by using pond water. Okay, the water he has taken the pond water for the first time, he observed some living cells. It was Robert Brown in the year 1831 who discovered the nucleus in the cell. So we have seen some dark spot like thing, right? The dark spots in the cell, okay? So this nucleus was exactly discovered by a person called as Robert Brown. So cell was discovered by Robert Hooke. Nucleus of the cell was discovered by Robert Brown in the year 1831. And who discovered the nucleus in the cell? And Purkinje in the 1839 coined the term protoplasm for the fluid substance of the cell. So as we are having some body parts, the cell is also having some cell parts. Okay, we are having eyes, nose, So even though the eyes, nose, all are menopauses, just for your understanding purpose, I am saying in this manner, okay? So cell is having some parts. So the main part of the cell is nucleus. So we are, the main part of our body is brain, right? So in this way, the cell is having some, the main part, and that main part is nothing but nucleus. So a scientist, another scientist, Purkinje, in 1839, he coined the term protoplasm. Okay, protoplasm is nothing but the liquid which is present in the cell. Okay, so we are having blood, right? So even blood is also cell only. But if we keep that thing aside, just for the simple understanding purpose, I'm going to convert these things, okay? So protoplasm is nothing but the liquid which is present in the cell. Okay, so the cell theory that all the plants and animals are composed of cells, and that the cell is a basic unit of life was presented by two biologists, Skridin and Skivan. So two scientists, they said that they completely gave the knowledge of the cells, we can say. So they said that all the living plants and animals are composed of cells, and the cell is the basic unit of life. So this thing is the cell theory. Cell theory is nothing but all the living organisms are made up of cells, and cells are the basic unit of life. So this is the theory, and this was presented by two biologists, Skridin and Skivan, in 1838 and 1839 respectively. So the cell theory was further expanded by Virchow by 1855 by suggesting that all cells arise from pre-existing cells. So according to Virchow, he said that from a single cell, we are going to get the other cells are produced. Okay, this is also a theory. That means one cell become two, and two cells become four. Four cells are going to become eight. Eight cells become 16. That means cells are going to double. So pre-existing cell, from one cell we are going to get the other cells. And this theory was produced by Virchow. With the help, the discovery of the electron microscope in 1940, it was possible to observe and understand the complex structure of the cell and its various organelles. So in previous simple microorganisms, only the Robert Hooke said that he can see the hexagonal shape. Okay, he said that only hexagonal shapes are seen. So next, according to Leeuwenhoek, he observed another cells, and Robert Brown has seen the, by improving the microscope, he seen the nucleus. So exactly by improving the microscope level, and we got a big developed microscope, and that is the electron microscope. By using this microscope, we can see all the parts of the cell, what are present in the, we can see the single cell and its parts completely, very clearly we can see through this electron microscope. So complex structure is nothing but the same. In single cell, all the parts we can see it very clearly, okay? Organelles are nothing but the parts of the cell. Cell and its various organelles are nothing but part of the cell. Parts of the cell, we are going to call it as what? Organelles. Okay? Remember this basic term so that you are going to understand the terms in your future easily. The invention of magnifying lenses led to the discovery of microscope world. So, as I said earlier, 10x, 20x. So, in this way, the invention of magnifying lenses made the things easier to understand, okay? So the microscopic world, that means a small, the things which we are not able to see through our eyes also, we can see through this microscope, okay? Microscope. So the name itself, micro means small organisms which we cannot see, okay? So scope, through this microscope, we can see these organisms or the things which we cannot see through our normal eyes. It is now known that the single cell may constitute the whole organism, as in amoeba. So amoeba is an organism and it is having a single cell. Okay, it is not having many cells. Okay, it is having a single cell. And not only amoeba, like Chlamydomonas, paramecium and bacteria, all these are single cellular organisms. These organisms are called as what? Unicellular organisms. Uni means single, cellular means cell. Okay, so these organisms are single celled organisms. If anyone asks you, give an example for single cell organism: Chlamydomonas, amoeba, and paramecium and bacteria. All these organisms are made up of single cell, and we are going to call these single cell organisms as unicellular. Uni means one. On the other hand, many cells group together in a single body and assume different functions in its form. Various body parts in multicellular organism. Multi means many. So we human beings are multicellular organisms. So dogs, cats, all these are multicellular. Multi means many. Cellular means many cells. Okay. And not only single cell is nothing, but in this unicellular organisms, all the work like respiration. Okay. Like respiration, reproduction, excretion. All these processes or all the work done by this single cell only. Here multicellular, coming to this multicellular organisms. Multicellular organisms are having many cells, and certain group of cells perform one activity and these cells perform. So let me say these are the cells. Okay. So this, they are going to respiration. Or there are few cells are going to do reproduction, few cells are going to do excretion. Okay, in this way different cells are organized to perform different activity. Okay, such as some fungi, plants and animals. So these are the multicellular organisms. Fungi, plants and animals are multicellular organisms. We can find out some names for more unicellular organisms. Every multicellular organism has come from a single cell. So we come from, and every multicellular organism, like fungi, plants and the animals, all we, as I said here, right? So according to whom, according to which out, what he said that from a single cell, other cells are came. So the same point is discussed here. Every multicellular organism has come from a single cell. So we came from a single cell only. How it has happened? Cells divide to produce cells of their own kind, and all cells just come from a pre-existing cells only. So one single cell, it has divided and it has become two cells of same shape and size. Okay, and these two cells are going to divide again, and we are going to get four cells. Got it? And these four cells again divide, they are converted into 8, and 8 cells divide and they become into 16. So in this way, multicellular organisms have come from a single cell. So this is the thing. So thank you for watching the video. For more videos, please subscribe the channel.